Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. O Lord, open thou our lips.
And our hearts shall sing of thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
For the Lord is
thank you. A reading from Ecclesiasticus. Then Elijah arose, a prophet like fire, and his word burned like a torch. He brought a famine upon them, and by his zeal he made them few in number. By the word of the Lord he shut up the heavens, and also three times brought down fire. How glorious you were, Elijah, in your wondrous deeds. Whose glory is equal to yours? You raised a corpse from death and from Hades by the word of the Most High. You sent kings down to destruction and famous men from their sick beds. You heard rebuke at Sinai and judgments of vengeance at Horeb. You anointed kings to inflict retribution and prophets to succeed you. You were taken up by a whirlwind of fire and a chariot with horses of fire. At the appointed time, it is written, you are destined to calm the wrath of God before it breaks out in fury, to turn the hearts of parents to their children, and to restore the tribes of Jacob. Happy are those who saw you and were adorned with your love, for we also shall surely live. Here ends the reading.
Thank you.
reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Now, if the ministry of death, chiseled in letters on stone tablets, came in glory so that the people of Israel could not gaze at Moses' face because of the glory of his face, a glory now set aside, how much more will the ministry of the Spirit come in glory? For if there was glory in the ministry of condemnation, much more does the ministry of justification abound in glory. Indeed, what once had glory has lost its glory because of the greater glory. For if what was set aside came through glory, much more has the permanent come in glory. Since then, we have such a hope, we act with great boldness, not like Moses, who put a veil over his face to keep the people of Israel from gazing at the end of the glory that was being set aside. But their minds were hardened. Indeed, to this very day, when they hear the reading of the Old Covenant, that same veil is still there, since only in Christ is it set aside. Indeed, to this very day, whenever Moses is read, a veil lies over their minds. But when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And all of us, with unveiled faces, seeing the glory of the Lord as though reflected in a mirror, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord, the Spirit. Here ends the reading.
Father Almighty. Mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the state.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people. In our time, O Lord,
because there is another fight for us, for we now, O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us. Before the passion of thy only begotten Son, didst reveal his glory upon the holy mount. Grant unto us that we, beholding by faith the light of his countenance, may be strengthened to bear our cross, and be changed into his likeness from glory to glory, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake.
Thank you.
Good evening. As Dean of St. Paul's Cathedral, it's my privilege to welcome you, whoever you are and wherever you find yourself in the journey of faith. Please know that you are most welcome to join us and participate in all that we do here at St. Paul's. I want to draw your attention to the Cathedral Life leaflet that has notices of a number of upcoming events, including on Tuesday, Shrove Tuesday, our famous annual tradition of the Zydeco Mass at 6 p.m., very different from Sunday's choral evensong, a very lively service. You can wear costumes and masks and bring beads and if you wish, sign up to buy a ticket for the Zydeco reception following the service, a dinner, New Orleans-style dinner. That's on Tuesday at 6 p.m. And then Ash Wednesday is, of course, right after it, and we have services at 7:30 a.m. and at noon and at 7 p.m. All throughout the day, as well as sending out a number of teams to do Ashes to Go around the city. And so Ashes will be administered at all those services on Ash Wednesday. I also want you to notice the notice about lay delegates for diocesan convention. This is the season of the year when we elect six lay parishioners to be our delegates. The convention isn't until November, but we are asked to make that election in the spring. And chapter will be selecting six individuals a week from Tuesday at their meeting. So if that is a ministry that interests you, please let me know if you want more information and or send in your name and a paragraph indicating why you feel called to that ministry to our administrator, Kathleen Burgess. And as we enter into Lent, if you find it useful, we have booklets of meditations, a meditation for each day of Lent. They're written by a number of different parishioners, and those booklets are available in the porches as you leave this evening. Please stand as you're able.
Let us pray. Grant, O God, that thy holy and life-giving Spirit may so move every human heart, and especially the hearts of the people of this land, that barriers which divide us may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease. That our divisions being healed, we may live in justice and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Direct us, O Lord, in all our doings with thy most gracious favor, and further us with thy continual help, that in all our works begun, continued, and ended in thee, we may glorify thy holy name, and finally, by thy mercy, abide in thy love forevermore, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.